Hello, welcome to my channel. I'm Tina. Last video, I asked why do we need a filter, okay? And we also have a feature, which is we want to for lots of servlets and GSP, we want only user session is valid. Those servlets and GSP are accessible. Otherwise, we may say access denied, right? And we mentioned filter can help to solve this kind of problems without repeat ourselves, right? And now, this video, I want to introduce what is a filter. And again, and also answer why filter can help us on the issue we occur or we run of. Okay. A filter is what? A filter is a useful piece of a code. Or you can think as a filter is a Java object, because eventually we will use the container will create this object for us. And that can transform the content of HTTP request, response, and header information. I copied this sentence from Jakarta EE with the specification, okay? And probably it's not very clearly explained what is a filter. A filter on the... Another term you can use, a filter is an object which can manipulate the request and the response, which is alter the request before the request goes to servlet, and also can change the response before the response sent back to the client. Okay. First, let's take a look at, don't take a look at the photo, the diagram on the right first. I will draw another one again from scratch, okay? So here, okay. Here, we already talked about inside our web container, okay? Here, this is our Tomcat. Tomcat will have a servlet A and have a servlet B and can have many servlet and GSPs, right? And this is our client, which is a browser. Well, previously, when the client make a request, go to a servlet. Here, the Tomcat, after receiving the request, right? Tomcat will directly forward the request to the servlet A, right? This request, okay? And then when in the servlet A, it has some response, then it will send it back to the client, right? This is a request, and here we have a response. This is a previous scenario. And what is servlet? Servlet, you can think as a man standing in the middle. So let me change the color here. Yeah, here, go, come out. Pen color. Let's use blue. How about blue? Because most of my viewers are male. So you can think the filter is a man standing in the middle. Here will be the filter. Okay. So now when a user make a request to /B, and we can configure the filter we will talk about later, okay? And this request, the Tomcat get the request, first say, okay, here have a filter. So it will delegate the request, go to the filter first. And in the filter, you can get the request and you can get a response. So in the filter, what you can do, you can get the request parameter, and you can also get the session to check the session is valid or not. And if valid, then you can delegate the request. Okay, sorry, not a delegate. Pass the request to the servlet. Okay, and also for the servlet B, okay, when you have a response, the response will also go to the filter first, And after filter, in the filter, what you can do? You can alter, you can change the response to be something else, okay? Or you can add something into the response, okay? And then it will go back to Tomcat, then it will go back to the user. So filter act as a man standing in the middle. Before your request go to the servlet, it will go to your filter. And before your response go back to the browser, it will go to your filter first, and it will go to your go back to the browser client. And this is how the filter works. And we have another diagram here. See here. We in the web container, we have a servlet 1, 2, 3, okay? And when we have a request comes, first it will go through a chain or a filter. This is called a filter chain, and we will discuss later, okay? So before this actual request from the client, which is reach the servlet 1, it will go to filter 1 and go to the filter 2. And then the request goes back. And for the response, it will do the reverse order. The response will go to the servlet filter 2 first, then go back to the filter 1, then go back to the client. Okay, and the filter chain is configurable, and we will discuss later. And take a look at the servlet 2. For a request made by client, okay, and before the request target on servlet 2, it will go to filter 1, filter 2, and filter 3. And before the response sent back to the client, it will go through filter 3 first, then filter 2, then filter 1. Okay, so here also have a filter chain. And for servlet 3, okay, it only has one filter. The request, it will go to the filter 3 first. And then the response will also go to filter 3, then go back to the client. So that is a filter, okay? Most of the time, generally speaking, in the filter, we don't actually provide the response, which means generally we don't, because the response mostly is a reply. Respond. Okay. Generally speaking, in the filter, we don't respond to a client request. Okay. Most of the time is the GSP or the servlet will respond to the request. And the filter, most of it is you want to do some tasks which probably want to alternate the attributes inside the request scope, session scope, or you want to get the parameters, and you want to modify some response, like minimize the image size or something, okay? And next slide, I will show you what are the tasks which filter is suitable. Here, I just pick some of them, not all of them, okay? Filters can perform many functions, and here I list some of them are very suitable for filter. First is authentication, and you can also do authorization, okay? Because authentication, like for if the user already logged in, okay, we just direct to the profile page or posts page or comment page or photo gallery page, right? And if it's not logged in, what we will do? We will redirect to the login page, right? And authorization is still same, like some of pages, like they like for Amazon, if we want to make some views review live, it must be reviewed by the Amazon, right? So that make the review live, it's only be accessible by the manager or admin. So you can do some checking, okay? Before go to that page or before that click button to make it live, we will have a test there. If it's a admin, right, we can do, and you can do logging and auditing. Suppose we want to log all the request parameters for every request, and what you will do, you cannot go to every Servlet, then track that, right? You can use a filter, okay? And you can also do auditing, like tracking users of a web application. You can do image conversion, like scaling maps and so on. You can do data compression to make the downloads smaller, like for the images or PDFs, for the CSS and the JS files, right? You can also do localization, like target the request and response to particular locale. And you can do encryption, tokenizer, mini type chaining, and caching. Lots of these kind of functions you can use a filter to achieve, okay? And a filter actually used in many places. The one I can think now is Spring Security. No matter you are using Spring Boot or not, okay? Because Spring Boot is not a replace other Spring framework, other Spring components in Spring framework, okay? Even though you are using Spring Boot and work with Spring Security, the fundamental is a Servlet filter. But it's not only one filter, it has a chain of filters used in Spring Security, okay? So filter is actually one of the most important component in Servlet development, okay? Three important component in Servlet development. One is Servlet, one is a filter, and one is a listener, okay? So now we are learning the second one, filter. So that's it for this video, and the next video we will talk more about Servlet filter. Thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you. Bye bye.